السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Do you memorize the vocabulary through lists? Do you think that memorizing vocabulary through the lists is the way to go about it? Does it really help in the long run? This is what we are going to talk about, inshallah ta'ala.
Ya talib al-ilmi qum la tanam fa inna az-zaman qada wa saram.
Marhaban, ismi Kashif, and you know me, right? I'm not a big fan of memorizing through lists because I think they're not very efficient in the long run. But I see many people do that. They take a whole list and memorize it. Don't get me wrong. This is like a good way for understanding the Quran because the Quran has a limited vocabulary, right? And we can sort it with the frequency list. Like you get these books, 80% of the vocabs of the Quran, 60% of the vocabs of the Quran, etc. And if you go through this list again and again and again, even though you might not understand grammar fully, you start to get a lot of vocabulary and you start to understand the verses of the Quran because you memorize the translation of that verse. But can you really do that for the whole language where it has like thousands of words? And is it really efficient for you to keep memorizing lists and lists and lists again and again in the long run? Or is reading the best option? So I was just surfing the net and I found this article which supports my point. And let's read it a little bit. It says, why vocabulary word lists don't work? It was written back in 2011. Most of us would agree with reading researchers that vocabulary development is critically important to improving reading comprehension. However, not all vocabulary instruction is effective or efficient. In many classrooms, the predominant means of vocabulary instruction is weekly vocabulary word list. So they give you a list. Right, they give you a whole list and you have to memorize this. But the problem is that this approach does not work. I totally agree with this. It does not work for adults mostly. Maybe it might work for kids. It's ineffective. Students memorize the list for Friday tests and forget half of them by next week. So by the next week, they forgot most of it. It's inefficient. Even if students were to remember all the, say, 20 words on the weekly vocabulary word list for the entire school year, they have only mastered 600 words, but the American lexicon is over 800,000 words. And that's English. English is, 800,000 words. So according to reading research, students need to learn 3,000 new words per year just to make year-to-year grade level progress. So learning only 600 words is a small drop in the ocean, in a very big bucket, he says, in an ocean, literally. But it is a bucket we desperately need to fill, especially for educationally disadvantaged students whose word poverty dooms them to the Matthew effect. To teach students 3,000 words a year, students would have to learn 17 words each school day, right, to learn 3,000 words. However, classroom intervention studies say that only 8 to 10 words can be retained through direct instruction in 1 week. So every week you can remember only 10 words. So what should we do? Three effective and efficient methods of vocabulary instruction. First, independent reading. Reading independently. Let us use Lewis as an example. Reading 30 minutes per day for homework at a rate of 200 words per minute. You might not read 200 words in the beginning. You might read 30 or 40 in Arabic or maybe less than that. For a total of 132 days means that Lewis would be exposed to 792,000 words in a whole year. If Lewis reads text as recommended 5% unknown words, level of word recognition recommended by reading researchers, this means that he would be exposed to 39,600 unfamiliar words per year. But when you're learning Arabic, you'll not find 5% unknown words. It'll be more or less 70 to 80% unknown words. So the number is quite high. Okay, because students learn between 5 and 10% of previously unknown words in a single reading. So when you're learning out of those 70%, you will learn only 10% or 5% conservatively. You'll never remember 100% of the unfamiliar words in the first go. So Lewis would have learned between 1980 and 3,960 new words at home, not to mention reading in the class, right? And then he gives another way, Greek and Latin word parts. This is for root letters of English. He goes back to root or suffix in Greek letters. And he gives that. And this is applicable to us. If you understand the root of the Arabic word using the Hans Word Dictionary, then it tells you, understand, okay, kataba. It gives you all, examples of katibun or maktubun and maktabun. Now you understand through sarf. Let me tell you this. You will hate reading in the beginning. You will hate it. Literally, I hated it. So because you would not understand anything when you start reading anything. Literally, you would not like it so much to read it. You have to look like for every new word, you have to go and search for the dictionary. But with time, you'll start enjoying it, inshallah ta'ala. So this is what I wanted to share. Not reading, voracious reading is a way for you to really get the vocabulary, not just some memorizing some lists and so on. If you are forced to do that, if you think that no, lists are the best and we have to memorize it and it's good, then it's fine. Alhamdulillah, remember, there is no right or wrong way to learn a language or learn vocabulary for that matter. Whatever suits you, whichever personality you have, whichever way suits you, but stick to it and finish it, right? Don't keep skipping between methods and skipping between ways and going from one place to another, right? This is me, what I believe and what I found working. So I thought I'd share that vocabulary memorizing through lists is not that good. It might help you in the starting, but later on for the long run, it's not really beneficial because you have to relearn the vocabulary again because it is void of context. You don't have any context when you're memorizing through lists. So you have to put that word in a context and then relearn that word again. Okay, Jazakallahu Khair, Barakallahu Fik. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.